Okay, hi, welcome back to channel teacher, the teacher in Sari. Okay, I know sudah lama sangat teacher tak bagi video kan, jangan marahlah, busy lah kan. So how are you guys kan? Okay, so yalah tak yalah banyak cakap lah kan, memang busy, alright. So busy because of that and plus teacher menunggu masa yang sesuai untuk memberikan kamu teknik-teknik menjawab lah kan, kalau tak siapa nak tengok kan. Semua busy, alright. Okay guys, yalah, welcome to my first video, alright, of soalan-soalan pelik biologi. You mesti ingat kenapa teacher bagi nama sedemikian untuk siri teacher kali ini kan? Because apabila sudah ada trial ni, teacher memang rasa kan, aduh lupa pasang mic lah pula. I hope you still can hear, you know. Ah. Kan, sudah lama tak buat, so forgot the flow already, alright. Okay, so the thing is apabila teacher tengok soalan-soalan trial tu kan, memang kesian lah orang, banyak sangat soalan hot, soalan pelik, soalan I don't know lah dari dunia mana mereka dapat ni. Honestly, I really don't know. But I feel that soalan-soalan jenis inilah yang perlu need to be addressed, perlu dibincangkan and perlu diberitahu kepada pelajar. So I really hope video teacher siri video soalan pelik-pelik biologi. Alright, soalan pelik-pelik biologi. Mungkin saya akan bagi, I'm not sure do the Canva dia, mungkin teacher akan bagi dia sembang soalan-soalan pelik biologi. Alright, okay. So whatever it is, siri teacher kali ini bukan untuk teknik menjawab. Because I know my video kan semua ada teknik menjawab, macam mana nak menjawab semua kan. So you follow that. Tetapi I think this time teacher nak menolong kamu dari segi membincangkan soalan-soalan yang hots lah, yang STEM hots, yang kebat kan, yang you all rasa sangat susah. Alright, okay, so tanpa melenggangkan masa, let's go into it. Okay, so every time teacher hanya hendak, okay, teacher hanya akan bincang 5 soalan saja. Because my aim is I tak nak the video go more than 30 minutes lah, alright. I don't want it to drag and so on because I know that saya ni pun jenis yang drag kan, alright. Okay, so I hope it will be really helpful lah kan. Tetapi dia tidak mengikut chapter ya, teacher ni just randomly pick from soalan trial negeri, soalan yang teacher rasa macam perlu dalam banyak sumber lah kan, teacher rasa macam soalan ni perlulah dibincangkan. Because saya rasa even my students SM Science Alam Shah, pun ramai yang they are struggling in this type of questions, alright. Okay, so the first question, okay, so yang ini sell lah. Oh guys, kalau kamu pada tahap ini, kalau kamu tidak kenal sel manusia dengan sel haiwan, oh my god, I really don't know what to say. Alright, okay, so by right, sekarang you all should tahu, kenal apa itu, apa dia sel haiwan dan sel tumbuhan. Now, not only that, by now you should be able to bagi tahu apa itu organel-organel. Alright, so teacher pilih ini pun satu daripada, thank you for soalan negeri. Memang teacher tak nak cakap ni saya buat, okay. So teacher memang ambil daripada soalan negeri lah. Yeah? Alright, tak ingatlah negeri mana kan. Alright, so yeah, okay. So apabila kita tengok soalan ini, alright, so by right ini adalah satu lukisan yang sangat-sangat jelas. Alright, very good, very beautiful lukisan. Alright, bermaksud anda kena tahu identify apa organel-organelnya. Alright, okay, satu telah diberikan untuk anda, jalinan endoplasma kasa, rough endoplasmic reticulum. Z, we don't know. Actually, it's a structure question. Dia ni ada banyak cabang-cabang dia. Tapi teacher tak nak bagi tahu what is this. Because aim teacher ialah untuk bincang soalan pelik-pelik. Alright, soalan yang macam kebat, soalan yang out of the box and all that. So that is my aim. So that is why I tak ambil semua bahagian soalan struktur. Ada soalan struktur, ada soalan essay ya. Yeah? Alright, so you kena tahu kenal by right what is this organel ini ya. Yeah? Okay, so kita bagi tahu ini ialah organelnya apa? Ini ialah lysosome. Alright. Lysosome, so yang ini look at the dia punya secretory vesicle kan, vesicle rembesan ni semua, and dia ni jauh sedikit daripada you punya nucleus. Yang ini ialah nucleus, Alright, nuclear. Sorry lah, teacher akan tulis English dengan BM together-together lah kan. Cannot lah do to in both languages. I'm really, really have no time for that. So I hope even the bilingual, the DLP, will watch this and also will take benefit from it. I try to make it in both languages, alright? Okay, so this is a Golgi apparatus. Just a Golgi. Alright, okay. Yang ini ialah centriol. So why is this central? Kerana dia berpasangan. Right. Okay, look at the question. Terangkan bagaimana struktur Y. So of course lah soalan yang sebelum itu kita sudah identify dah apa tu. Alright. So so you kena tahu itu adalah lysosom. So berkaitan dengan fungsi sel leukosit. So that is how. You see, this is how soalan-soalan kebat, soalan-soalan pelik dia. Alright, bermaksud dia ini bukan tanya, ah ini apa, ini apa kerja, ini apa, ini apa kerja. No. Okay, not anymore. Dia akan tanya apa kerja ini dalam suatu sel yang spesifik. Maksud, bermaksud you kena tahu kaitkan apa fungsi lysosom ini dengan fungsi sel leukosit. Baru dia ngam. Alright, okay, and also dalam mekanisme, tengok dah, dia dah bagi dah clue. Alright, so if it's in English, explain how structure Y. So now Y you have identified as lysosomes and it is involved in the function of leukocyte in the body defense mechanism. Alright, so nowadays kebat question, like I said, it is very much involving not only knowing what is the function of that particular organelle, but also you should be able to relate to what is the function of an organelle with another specific type of cells. Alright, so this is a very high level question here that you're facing. So that is why they have allocated 3 marks. Alright, this is a structure question, obviously. So how do you need, okay, so that is why actually guys, I'm telling you there is no shortcut for it. You must be able to, you should be able to, how to say, you when you do more questions, this is how we call it, it's just a mastery. So when you see more questions, when you encounter more of this type of question, then you learn how to relate. Alright, it's not a gift, you know. Kan, ini bukan gift. Alright, so apabila kita buat banyak latihan, that is when you akan memahirkan diri kamu dalam menjawab soalan-soalan sebegini. Guys, I'm really sorry. You kena buat banyak soalan. Okay, kena buat banyak latihan. Itu saja caranya. Alright, okay, let's look at jawapan. So apabila kita tengok sel leukosit ini adalah sel darah putih, white blood cell. Alright, sel darah putih. Alright, sel darah putih. And dia nak dalam mekanisme pertahanan badan. Leukocyte, mekanisme pertahanan badan. Definitely, but please do not go into antibody. Because apabila soalan ni teacher bagi pada student, kan ada juga yang bagi tahu ini adalah untuk menghasilkan antibody. Aduh, manalah lysozyme untuk antibody. Kan, so lysosom ini untuk antibody, please lah kan. So no, it is actually untuk mekanisme barisan pertahanan kedua, second line defense, which is by phagocytosis. Alright, so apa yang dia buat ialah dia akan bergabung dengan phagosome. Phagosome ialah apabila dia telah mengepung. Alright, so apabila they have engulfed a certain type of bacteria or virus. Alright. So apabila dia telah mengepungnya, dia menjadi satu jenis vacuole makanan, something like vacuole makanan lah kan. So ini yang dia akan rembeskan dengan lysosome tu. Alright, so dia akan merembeskan lysozyme. Ini ialah lysozyme adalah enzyme. Okay, lysozyme. Why is it the spelling is wrong? It's lysozymes, right? So it's a type of enzyme. So enzyme ini actually apa yang dia akan buat ialah dia akan destroy. Why? Because dia akan mencernakan. Itu yang dia kata bakteria di dalam phagosome akan dimusnahkan, akan diuraikan oleh phagocyte. Okay guys, another thing. Sorry lah because you know lah teacher teachkan all boys school kan, because I say guys je. Nevermind lah, you all also guys for me lah kan. Okay, so one thing that you have to understand, sometimes the saya sangat-sangat kesian apabila pelajar ini, murid lah kan, tak boleh panggil pelajar. Okay, murid ini apabila dia tidak pandai menggunakan perkataan. Right, sometimes the one word can alter the whole meaning. In fact, can change the whole destiny of that answer. Alright, so you have to be careful apa jenis jawapan, apa jenis words for you to use. Alright, okay, so ini adalah mana-mana tiga, you akan dapat tiga markah di sini. Alright, so it's a phagocyte, it's a phagocytosis, dia ni adalah barisan pertahanan kedua, dia bergabung dengan phagosome, merenggaskan lysozymes, so bakteria itu dimusnahkan. So bermaksud di sini you telah, struktur Y ini you telah mengaitkan dengan fungsi sel leukocyte. Alright, so that means can you see the question? The answer is arranged in such way that finally you have identified the function of the leukocyte. Alright, so that is how you beautifully do your answer. Alright, so at the end of the day, your answer must reflect what the question is about. That is actually one of the tips that I give you. Because sometimes when you read your answer, kita tak boleh guess apa soalan dia tau. If it's a good answer, bermaksud dia akan relate balik kepada question itu. Kan? So, ini adalah fungsi leukocyte. Nampak? Sebab itu dia ini relate to the function. Alright? So, don't worry. Teacher, try lah. Try my best to put every week at least soalan-soalan pelik macam ni. Teacher akan bincangkan yang mana teacher rasa, oh my god, this is actually benda yang teacher kena bagi tahu. I try my best lah to introduce this type of questions. Alright? Okay, so the next question. Wajarkan, inilah perkataan-perkataan yang saya tahu anda sangat-sangat takut, menakutkan, menggerunkan, seram, sejuk tengoknya. Yeah, okay. Tapi jangan bimbang, actually kita hanya guna bombastic words, but actually it doesn't mean that bombastic stuff. Because dia hanya membawa dua markah mah. Right, so no need to worry. So you just terangkan sahaja. Alright, so sekarang dia tanya mengapa ribosom terlekat kepada jalinan endoplasma. Bermaksud you kena tahu, bukan saja kena tahu apa fungsi ribosom, you also kena tahu apa fungsi jalinan endoplasma kasa. That means you not only should be able to know what is the function of a ribosome, but it also have to justify, also has to give a proper relationship, not the relationship, reason. Okay, why is it attached to rough endoplasmic reticulum particularly? Alright, don't say that's how God made it. Alright, please. Okay, so now we are going to analyze why God made it such way. Alright, okay. So why is because ribosome, the function is to synthesize protein. Fungsi ribosom adalah untuk mensintesiskan protein. Tapi ribosom ni dia macam mana tau? Dia ribosom tu dia sudah sintesis. Sudah. Kerja dia beres. Tapi you kena angkut dia because protein yang kau susah payah buat ini kan bukan hanya gunakan di dalam sel. Kadang-kadang you kena guna out of the cell. You have to make an extra cellular enzyme. You have to make a specific hormone. Isn't it? So that is the reason. Kejap, teacher tengok. Teacher ni recording tak? Recording juga. Kadang-kadang kan tengok-tengok dah shock cerita lama ni. Tengok-tengok lupa tekan recording. Pernah berlaku tau. Oh my god. Right? Okay, so yeah. So kerja dia ialah to synthesize protein. Tapi apa fungsi jalanan endoplasma kasa? Angkut, transport. Alright, so that is why ribosom ni ibarat kilang tau. You punya endoplasma kasa ini sebagai highway, you know. So when you are manufacturing something in a factory, you kena cari jalan to bring it to distribute it. Distribute, that's the way. Okay, distribute it. So in order for you to distribute, you have to make sure your kilang is very, very near to your highway. Okay, so that is the idea. Roughly lah, teacher try to explain lah supaya kau faham kan. Alright, so this is the idea. Alright, okay, so dia akan angkut pergi mana? Dia akan pergi ke jasad Golgi. So apa fungsi jasad Golgi ni? Supaya protein itu dan lain-lain. Because dia okay, that's the thing. Kau jangan cerita function of the Golgi apparatus. Kalau you cerita pun, dia tak ada markah tau. Kan? So because yang ini dia diangkut ke jasad Golgi ni is directly connected to the function of the jalinan endoplasma kasa. Sebab itu dia memberi markah. Tapi kalau kamu cerita apa yang berlaku di jasad Golgi ni, memang tak dapat markah. Because itu bukan apa yang dia tanya. Tahu? So you all lah, the problem is lah, you all lah selalu tak jawab soalan. You hanya tulis apa yang apa yang you hafal, apa yang you baca dekat buku. Please lah, you have to understand the stimulus. You have to understand the question and answer accordingly. Lah, dah start berletih lah pula kan teacher ni. Macam cakap dengan budak saya sendiri. Alright, but anyway, yeah. If you're watching me, that means you are my budak lah. Alright, so that is why. Okay, so apabila it's directly connected, kita bagi markah. Tetapi apabila you pergi cerita tentang jasad Golgi and so on, sorry, no marks there. Right? Okay, so moving on to the next question. Raja Dua. Ha. Like I said, saya teacher campur-campur lah mana-mana. So, the next itu, kalau you sudah watch this video, you bagi komen. Teacher boleh tak bincang tentang benda ni? So, bagilah teacher some idea kan untuk membincangkan soalan-soalan pelik. Kan? Pelik. Kan? That's the thing. You bagi teacher idea. Apa kalau ada idea teacher saya nak soalan ini atau soalan daripada bab ini atau kan? You bagi teacher idea. Teacher try to do before your exam comes. Right? Okay. So, Raja Dua menunjukkan struktur sendi lutut seorang pesakit osteoarthritis yang merupakan seorang atlet. You see ya, you kena baca soalan tau. Di dalam soalan itu dia mempunyai banyak-banyak information. There's so much information there. Alright? He said they are showing a knee joint, right? But he's not only an osteoarthritis patient, but he's also an athlete. That means there's something related to the athleticism will come as a question. Alright, so that is why always itu yang teacher bagi tahu. Even last year punya, dia punya teknik tidak berubah. Tolong underline what is the most important thing in the question, you know. Right, okay. So, diagram shows the structure of osteoarthritis before, so that you ada perbandingan, alright? During and after treatment. I don't know, you boleh nampak atau dia macam retak-retak lah sikit. Ha, teacher lukis lah kan. Okay? Because teacher nampak, I don't know, dekat screen tu kau nampak ke tak? Ha, dia macam ni, macam kena petir je kan. So actually these are some, it's worn off, it's cracked, you just name it. But basically it's still injury. Alright? Okay. So, apa maksud osteoarthritis? Bermaksud you kena tahu apa penyakit itu. Osteoarthritis ialah apabila you punya cartilage. Alright? Cartilage ini ialah rawan lah kan. Dalam Melayu kita panggil dia sebagai tulang rawan. Tulang rawan dia ni telah haus. Alright? Exhausted. Not, we don't call it exhausted. We call it as wear. It's worn. Wear and tear. Alright? We don't call it exhausted. Don't directly translate. You know, hilarious lah you guys. Right. Okay. So, pesakit otitis bermaksud apabila soalan ini kenapa dia merupakan satu soalan pelik. Hot. Kebat. Kan? Why is because you bukan saja kena tahu apa tu osteoarthritis, you kena tahu apa masalah dia and bagaimana masalah ni diselesaikan. Alright, so that is why. Alright, okay. So, look at the question. Okay, that was the situation lah. Sekarang, kita tengok apa soalan dia. Ini dia soalannya. Itu tadi tu mukadimah tau. Bagaimanakah permukaan plastik dan logam membantu atlet ini meneruskan kehidupan harian, not only for his daily life, kan, daily life and also his training. Dia ni kan atlet, right, Allah teacher lupa tanda soal, point, kan, so he's also an athlete, right, so we don't know, okay, so that is the thing, okay, so we want to give back the quality life back to him, right, so how you want to do it. So, soalan ini membawa 5 markah. Alright? So, usually kalau dia 5 markah ini bermaksud ini adalah satu soalan essay lah. Alright? So, essay. So, most probably dia ini adalah untuk section C atau section B. We don't know. Alright? Tapi penting dia soalan pelik. Kan? Soalan pelik. Kenapalah teacher bagi nama macam tu? Entah, I just feel like so pelik kan budak tanya. Teacher, how to answer this question? So pelik, so pelik. So, I thought like, I just name it pelik. Alright, okay, so logam, so sekarang dia sudah bagi plastik dan metal, plastik and metal. But then, you kena tahu plastik di mana, apa tu, plastik di mana, logam di mana, kan? Ha, so bermaksud logam ini adalah di sebagai permukaan tulang atas. See, dia ni adalah permukaan tulang atas. Okay, dan tulang bawah. Tulang bawah entahlah soalan ni tak tunjuklah. Tetapi antara dia tu ada bearing plastik. So itu yang apabila kamu huraikan. Eh guys, you know what? Apabila this is what they call as a stimulus, you know, this one, all this picture and all that, they call that a stimulus. Alright? So the stimulus ini can come in any way. Dia boleh dipersembahkan dalam apa jua cara. Dalam bentuk carta alir, dalam bentuk graf, dalam bentuk pictures, dalam bentuk statement, apa-apa saja. Alright? So apabila kamu menganalisis, kan? So kamu tengok soal, kamu tengok dia punya picture tu, lepas tu you you try to tell logam ni adalah permukaan atas, dia di bawah ni dia punya kedudukan itu, you satu, okay, macam inilah. Satu gambar raja, apabila you huraikan dia dalam bentuk ayat, you akan dapat markah. Alright? So dia tunjuk satu, like contohlah macam yang ini apa kan, dia kata labelkan kan. Sama juga apabila dia bagi satu gambar, dia bagi metal surface tapi dia tak bagi di mana. Tapi apabila kamu huraikan dia, ini kita panggil, that's why ini semua adalah soalan yang aras yang sangat tinggi. Because dia ini adalah soalan aras analysis. Very important. Because apabila you explaining the stimulus when you are, kan, apabila you explaining the, you know, gambar raja tu bermaksud you are, you know, kan. So, okay, logam sebagai permukaan tulang atas dan tibia sebagai tulang bawah. And plastik adalah antara. You tak boleh make sure, you know, kasih logam dengan tu nanti bergeser nanti kan. Kan, that's why you must have a plastic there as a cushion. Kan, itu dia. Tengok. So, bertindak sebagai plastik ini bertindak sebagai tulang rawan. Logam ini adalah struktur yang memperkukuhkan kawasan yang lembut ini. Kan hujung-hujung tulang ini lembut tau. Alright, they are much softer compared to the upper part ini. So, this tulang, this apabila you letak logam ni, dia memperkukuhkan. They actually make it much stronger. Alright, so, and the plastic is actually to reduce the friction between these two metal surfaces. Right, so that is why the plastic is as a tulang rawan, functions as a cartilage, because that is your biggest issue now. The issue now is your cartilage because you are an osteoarthritis patient. Kamu ni adalah pesakit osteoarthritis, bermaksud you punya cartilage, rawan kamu telah haus. Right, you see, this is basic degeneration of the body lah kan. Apabila kita muda kan, your regeneration is much faster compared to your regeneration. Alright, you tak payah buat apa, you tak payah, I know, pakai krim ini, pakai krim itu, you tak payah minum itu, minum suplemen ni. Automatically your regeneration is faster. You know lah, you kita punya per growth kan. Alamak, nak buat sigmoid tapi jadi pelik lah pula. Soalan pelik, teacher pun beli, kan? Macam ni kan, dia jadi macam ni kan? Why is because after some time, usually when you hit your 30s, 35 and above, what happens is your degeneration is faster compared to your regeneration. Bermaksud, degenerasi, I don't know how to say in Malay lah, kan? So, you membaik pulih tu lebih rendah daripada merosot. Something like that. Alright, so that is why after some certain age, if you don't take care, you don't exercise, your badan will your badan will lose the shape, your face will lose this, you know, all this lah, kan? So same thing here, apabila kita meningkat usia atau kita banyak menggunakannya, so dia akan, slowly dia akan haus lah, because badan kita dia tidak akan ganti balik. Kan, so that's why kena ambil supplement, that's why kena exercise, right? Okay, so ini dia lah point-point dia, kan? So the function of the cartilage itu ialah untuk mengurangkan geseran, to reduce the friction. So ini merupakan satu rawatan sendi, sakit sendi yang teruk. Sakit sikit-sikit masa hujan, sakit sikit-sikit, it's okay, you know. When it involves, you know, you cannot do a certain activity because your knees are paining. Alright, nak pergi hiking tak boleh, kaki sakit. Nak jalan pergi shopping tak boleh, kaki sakit. So that is when you need medical attention because it reduces the quality of your life. Alright, remember that. So you sikit-sikit sakit ini actually you can rectify on its own. Atau apabila sakit sendi yang teruk sehingga kamu tak boleh jalan, kamu tak boleh buat apa-apa aktiviti harian. So that is when you need to do this. Alright, so atau kecederaan lutut. Alright, as a treatment for severe knee pain or knee injury. So dia akan mengurangkan kesakitan. Eh, sakit tau. I don't know lah. I don't have it. Touch wood. I hope I don't get it. But they said it's going to be super. It's going to be very, very painful. Alright. And of course, kenapa kita buat ialah because untuk meningkatkan kualiti hidup. Alright. So dia not only dia boleh meneruskan kehidupan harian, but who knows, maybe dia boleh buat latihan sukan. I think this is a common injury among footballers. Kan, if boys, they know lah, footballers kan, it's because they are using their knees a lot for their training and so on. After certain age itu, apabila dia ada injury itu, they cannot perform. Especially these players who you buy for millions of dollars, pounds, dollars, whatever, alright? They cost millions, alright? So of course, you can't afford to, you know, they still have to make sure that they deliver, kan, dia punya service itu kan. So they have no choice but to go for this type of treatment. Right, so I hope this helps. Okay, next. The next question is, pada pendapat anda, ini pun satu lah, apabila kamu nampak soalan pada pendapat anda ni, you rasa ini semua adalah soalan yang sangat-sangat susah. Alright, but remember, apabila dia kata pada pendapat anda, you punya pendapat ini mesti di lingkungan biologi. Ini ialah lingkungan biologi. Lingkungan biologi. Right. Jangan kasih pendapat ini, you bagi semua pendapat politik, pendapat agama awak semua. Tak payah. Kan? Even though this based on your opinion, ini your opinion, your pendapat ini must be still confined within your biological knowledge. Do not go beyond that. Right. Pada pendapat anda, macam-macam you all. Kan? So please lah. Right. Okay, so ini pun membawa 5 markah. So obviously these two questions ini it's a essay question lah, right? Okay, so apabila kita buat soalan ini, kita rasa wah bestnya kalau saya dapat masalah ni, saya buat je surgery ni, kan? Tetapi you kena ingat everything has a side effect when it's not your own body, right? So in this case, what happens? Ini yang dia suruh bincangkan, kan? So apa yang you mungkin berlaku? Alright, so sendi palsu ini mungkin menjadi longgar. Sometimes when they're doing it, the procedure itu, maybe it has dislodged. Alright, so making it not that, not that perfectly fitted. Something like that lah, not perfectly, not a perfect fit. Alright, atau dia berubah posisi due to your, like he's an athlete. Kan, so it's always, because apabila kamu fix something, dia bukan natural, there's always a, macam potong kereta lah. Kereta potong kereta kan. Apabila ada accident, tiba-tiba tengok dia punya muka tu, dia punya engine tu gone another way. Right, because of the impact gitu kan. So that is the same thing. Apabila you letak something yang unnatural there, automatically, yeah, it always happens, right? Okay, so the next is dia boleh kurang berfungsi seperti dikehendaki. Because you'll never know how your body is going to accept it. So by right, the ideally dia mesti, apabila dia tunjuk, the doctor is painting the picture to you. Wah, saya boleh jalan, saya boleh lari, saya boleh lompat, saya boleh jadi Superman. Itulah the thing that they painted. But sometimes, kalau nasib kamu tak baik, dia mungkin, in fact, dia mungkin akan jadi lagi worse, you know. Alright, so mungkin dia kurang boleh berfungsi seperti yang dikehendaki. Alright, maybe you wanted to become a Superman, at the end of the day, only you can only become a normal man. Right, so that is how it is. So it may not function as it was intended. Alright, due to a lot of reasons. Dia ada banyak faktor. Alright, and the plastic also boleh menjadi haus apabila the logam ini constantly bergeser antara mereka. Right, so that is another thing. So kalau dia ni haus, bermaksud you have to change it often depending on often Melayu panggil apa how you guna lah. Kalau selalu you guna, so of course benda ni akan menjadi haus, just like your brake pad lah kan. Kau ni tak memandu kereta, you tak tahu. But if you interested lah, like your brake pad. If you always brake. Some people have this habit, you know, when they're driving, brake, sikit-sikit, brake. So what will happen is your brake pad ini akan menjadi haus. So you have to ganti sooner than you should. Right? So okay. Then another thing, saraf dan salur darah. kan? So during the procedure itself, mungkin dia ni tercedera. So what will happen is they will reduce the sensitivity. They will reduce the aliran darah, oxygen, nutrient to that particular part. Alright, so this may cause that part itu mungkin tidak mendapat apa yang dia sepatutnya dapat. So mungkin you lose sensation there, sensation rasa, kan, dari rasa di sana, atau salur darah di sana tu ada masalah, so you tak dapat flow di sana. Alright, so it also can cause allergy. Alright. So allergy ni, remember, when not everybody, when a medical procedure ni, it not necessarily might be fantastic for you. Alright, it all depends on macam mana badan kita ambil. Alright, so what works for one person, it not necessarily work for another person. Okay, so apabila dia ni, okay, for one person, oh, dia buat ini, wah, so nice, right? Dia buatlah apa procedure kan. You follow the same thing ini, it's not necessarily sama untuk you. Alright? Because human body, I tell you, there's no idealism. Alright? So that is the idea. Eh? So boleh juga menyebabkan pergerakan. Kelemahan pada pergerakan. Like I said, it not might not work as intended. Alright? So that is the issue lah. Alright, okay. Then, okay, question number 3. Ha, ini tentang vaksin. I feel vaccine might take a center stage. I don't know because I feel macam banyak soalan negeri. Right? You cannot deny it, you know. Soalan negeri, you know, banyak saya teacher jumpa yang dia banyak ada tentang vaksin. Because knowing that nowadays the current hot topic kita ni adalah vaksin, kan? So might as well, you know, kita tengok apa itulah, kan? Tetapi saya memang sengaja tak bagi COVID. Alright? I didn't give COVID. Why is because nanti esok lusa, next year ke apa ke kan, pelajar lain tengok mungkin that time COVID is over. Hopefully. Alright. So it is still, it doesn't become obsolete lah. So sebab itu teacher ambil soalan sebegini. Iaitu pemvaksinan. Okay, vaccination plan for children and infants. Alright, in Malaysia. Alright. So okay, adakah tengok soalan macam ni lah yang anda takut rasa sangat kebat sungguh kan? Adakah anda bersetuju? Berikan pendapat anda. Do you agree? Give your opinion. But remember, even though they ask anything, any way they ask also, your argument must be within the knowledge of bio. Okay, your argument must be within the knowledge of bio. You punya point-point kamu ni mestilah dalam lingkungan biologi. Jangan keluar daripada itu. Alright, okay, so of course lah you setujulah kan. Do you agree kan dengan rancangan pewangsinan bagi bayi dan kanak-kanak yang dicadangkan? Berikan pendapat tentang kepentingan. Alright, and also mengikut, bukan ikut suka kamu, mengikut jadual tau. So give your opinion about it. Alright, so this is a 10 marks question. Easily 10 marks. Okay, so apabila you express your opinion, you akan dapat satu markah di sini. Selepas itu, vaccination ini ialah apa jenis, keimunan jenis apa? Ia adalah keimunan aktif buatan. Kenapa kanak-kanak diberi, bukan orang besar kan? Sekarang, waktu dulu lah kan, dulu kanak-kanak. So now look at the day and the age. Ini orang besar pun kena ambil. Why is because sistem imun kanak-kanak atau infant. Sorry, ini kanak-kanak in English is infant. Because infant is bayi. Alright, bayi or kanak-kanak ini adalah lemah. Mereka ni mudah kena jangkitan. Alright, so sebab itu. So, vaksin ini pula function dia ialah untuk merangsang. To trigger the antibody production. It's like a fire drill, you know. So you give apa tu kan, I think you all know kan, vaksin ini dia akan bagi bakteria ke virus yang telah dilemahkan, right? So apa yang dia akan buat ialah macam fire drill. Apabila you, badan kamu sudah nampak benda tu, dia akan make antibody against it, right? So untuk melawan penyakit, yeah, to fight the infection. Alright, but sometimes the vaccine itu mungkin memerlukan satu atau beberapa dos, like how we are going to see nowadays, like kita perlukan 3 dos because you kena ingat. Okay, kenapa ramai tanya, teacher why not one dose? Kan ramai halah malasnya kena ambil dos booster lagi ke kan? You have to remember you are dealing with a virus, you know. It's a life threatening virus. So dia mesti ada, you tak boleh bagi dia dengan kuat sangat. Alright. Ha. Then is if you bagi dia yang kuat sangat tu, baik, might as well they get that penyakit and die. Right. So you kena bagi dia sikit-sikit supaya badan kamu mampu menerimanya. Sebab itu dia perlu ada beberapa dos. And the biggest problem with this virus only, they're very good at mutating. They're superbly expert in mutating. That is why they can survive for very long. So the because the antibody ini adalah sangat-sangat specific. They're very specific. Apabila dia tak kenal macam benda yang sama, macam adik-beradik lah, another new virus comes, tapi mereka adik-beradik, dia tak boleh, antibody yang dihasilkan tu tidak berupaya melawannya. So that is why every time you have to take a booster dose and so on. Kan? Tetapi you tak boleh bagi dia dalam single dose. Cannot. You still need to have a booster because remember you are dealing with a virus, life-threatening virus, virus yang boleh membahayakan diri awak. So dia tak boleh bagi serentak. Okay, baby pun kan, masa baby pun kan, ibu kamu pergi ambil 3 kali, 4 kali beberapa bulan tau, kena pergi beratur ambil. Okay, say thank you to your mommy, right, and your daddy, right, because of them you all are alive. Right, so why is supaya kita boleh mencapai aras immunity, arak kadulai salah eja pula immunity, to achieve immunity, because apabila you ada dia ada satu aras, so you kena reach that aras baru you selamat, kan? So it's like you know the limbo, limbo game, you know, kan, limbo game tu. So dia ni aras dia ni semakin meningkat, Omicron, kau lah nama lah, Delta lah, apalah kan. So you kena ambil satu, you kena ambil satu, you kena ambil satu, sehingga you always go above the immunity level. Alright, so why this antibody ni so cekap? Because sekali you dia sudah tahu macam mana nak buat antibody ni, dia akan menghasilkan memory cells. It's a beautiful mechanism. Alright, so it's like they have an auto memory. Apabila dia sudah tahu buat the recipe macam mana nak buat antibody tu, dia tahu. So dia akan simpan. So the next time, because you have to understand, buat antibody ni bukan satu hari tau. It's not a one day affair. It's not. Alright, so dia ni apabila dia ada tu, dia akan if the real one comes, like I said, this is like a fire drill, you know. Fire drill Melayu panggil apa? I don't know lah, latihan kebakaran, latihan kebakaran, kan? So you bagi dia acah-acah dulu, kan? Dia know how to do. The next time the real one come and attack your body, cepat-cepat boleh menghasilkan. Itu sebabnya serta-merta ini mendapat markah. That is the beauty of vaccine. When the real one comes, your body immediately will get. Okay, immediately. Alright, so apabila ada jangkitan tu, dia immediately akan menghasilkan antibody, right? So dia boleh mengurangkan kadar penyakit, right? Ain kanak-kanak, right? So and not only that, kadar penyakit ini boleh mengurangkan mortality, kematian, alright? If you go medical term tu, they don't call death rate, right? They call it mortality, right? So mortality rate. Right, so this inilah point-point dia, kan? Okay, go to the next question, number 4. Proses menghasilkan vaksin melawan virus dan bakteria mengambil beberapa langkah. Langkah dimulakan dengan mengenal pasti kod genetik virus. Of course, you want to find an antidote for it. Of course, you know how does it function. You kena tahu dia punya DNA, constitution dia tu macam mana, how they work. You kena study dia dulu tau. Kan? So pada pendapat anda, mengapakah langkah ini mesti dilakukan? Alright, untuk menghasilkan vaksin. Of course lah, you ingat vaksin ini apa? Kacang cendol kah? Cendol ada kacang kah? I think ada. Kan? Simply suka-suka kau nak apa, kau tambah. Macam kau pergi buffet kan, kau tambah apa suka. Tak boleh. You kena tengok siapa enemy awak. You kena baca dia dengan betul-betul. Baru you boleh hasilkan antibody, vaksin against it. Alright? So this is a 3 marks question. Question 3 markah. Supaya dapat boleh mengeluarkan bahagian-bahagian tertentu daripada kod genetik. Because the virus ini, dia bukan macam manusia jugalah. It's not all the time jahat, you know. Dia mesti ada beberapa bahagian dalam kod genetik dia yang menyebabkan dia itu virulent. Or they, you know, they are not to say virulent. Like dia macam invasive. Right? So itu dia. So apa yang you try to isolate. Itu yang actually if you isolating bermaksud you have studied thoroughly their genetic coding. Alright, macam coding komputer lah pula kan. So apabila you tahu apa sebabnya dia jadi jahat lah. So itu dalam ada dalam DNA dia tu. So apabila you boleh lemahkan that particular part. So apabila you lemahkan, dia kata lemah virus ini bukan virus itu. What you do is you just turn off the switch yang menyebabkan dia jahat. Kan? Turn off the switch supaya dia tak jahat. So virus ini virus tapi dia datang tu dia tak boleh buat apa. Macam itulah. Itu yang menyebabkan virus itu menjadi tidak aktif, inaktif atau non-virulent. Alright, to weaken the virus. Alright, so virus ini tetapi dia masih lagi mempunyai antigen. Antigen itu yang menyebabkan you punya body akan menghasilkan antibody. Kan? Tetapi apa yang menyebabkan penyakit dalam virus itu you weaken. You switch off. Kan? You cari mana dia punya switch itu, kau switch off dia. Ha, kan? So virus ini masih berfungsi. Ha, ini dia. This is the most crucial part. It is still a virus. It still has its antigens. But it cannot cause infection. Kan? Ha, cannot cause being infection. Virus atas nama sajalah. Ha, macam itulah kan? Virus atas nama saja. Tapi dia tidak boleh menyebabkan. So you benda bagi ni pada dia. So now your body will know, ini ada benda baru masuk kita punya badan. Okay, jom kita make antibody. Right. So that is how it is. So when the real one comes pun, dia tahulah macam mana nak, how to fight this fella. Alright. So tubuh masih dapat mengenali kod genetik virus dan menghasilkan tindak balas antibody. Alright, so this is how it is. So apabila kita kata lemahkan tu bukan virus tu, because virus itu tidak boleh, we cannot say virus is hidup, you know, because dia at the end of the, in the first place it's not alive, right? It's actually like an entity. Dia hanya boleh membiak. So kita tak boleh guna perkataan hidup di sini. Alright, that is my personal opinion because virus are not alive. Right, so you can say they are functioning, tetapi jangan kata virus ini hidup. Yeah, alright, okay. Next question number 5. Kan teacher tercampur-campur lah. Okay, orkid liar pada pohon besar. So bermaksud yang ini adalah you kena able to know that this is commensal. Macam mana nak eja ni? Commensalism. Okay, commensalism. Alright, okay. So huraikan bagaimana orkid itu beradaptasi untuk meneruskan kemandiriannya. Alright, so you need to know apabila kamu tahu hubungan dia adalah commensalism, bermaksud you should know what is the ciri-ciri dia. Alright, so this is how. Okay, ini adalah satu soalan di form 5, I think nutrition kan, it's the type of nutrition of the plant itu. So ini pun bahagian plant ni memanglah kalau keluar kebat ke atau soalan pelik macam ni kan, memang you all ni tak boleh nak jawab. Kan? Ha, so you nak tak boleh nak jawab. So itu sebabnya teacher pilih soalan ni supaya you tahu apa dia benda ni, bukan benda ni lah, tumbuhan ini kan, tumbuhan ini. Alright, oh my god, sorry, 42 minutes, I only intended it to half an hour. Teacher ni kan cakap je lah kerjanya, tak ajar kan, ajar lah tapi talking too much. Alright, so huraikan bagaimana beradaptasi. That means what is so special? What is, you see, apabila benda ni adaptasi bermaksud dia ada something special feature. Ada dia punya satu kesesuaian yang sangat special membolehkan dia boleh hidup di tempat sebegitu. Itu yang you kena identify. Alright, so describe how an orchid is adapted to continue survival of its species. So orchid merupakan tumbuhan epiphyte. It's an epiphyte. Alright, so bukan happy feet, epiphyte. Alright, so perumah dan dia akan hidup pada tumbuhan lebih tinggi. So it's an epiphytic, it grows on another plant, it has a host. But they don't harm the host. Okay, that is the beauty of commensalism. Right? Tetapi the perkataan commensalism ini, I'm not sure, in the marking scheme tidak diberi markah because dia hanya memerlukan adaptasi, dia tidak bertanya apa ciri dia. Right? Okay, so that is the thing. Right? Okay, so dia, why dia pergi duduk atas orang lain ini? Supaya untuk mendapatkan lebih banyak cahaya matahari. Alright, so dia juga mempunyai batang yang bengkak, kan? If you see properly, kan, kau manalah ada masa nak pergi tengok pokok-pokok ni semua, kan? Usually, they have a batang yang bengkak untuk menyimpan air. And usually, mereka ada cara untuk to trap, alright? To store, to trap the rainwater or dews. Alright, so mereka memang pandai buat benda tu. Alright, and dia juga akan menyerap, ini menyerap nutrient di celah-celah batang pokok perumah. Kadang-kadang dia punya akar itu, dia make it in such way that banyak semut hidup di sana. So apabila semut hidup, takkan semut kan dia pergi cari benda, dia akan cari ini, dia akan cari apa tu, dia akan letak tempat dia. So, kan suka kumpul. Right, so apabila dia kumpul ni, lepas tu apabila benda tu mereput, our friend boleh serap sahaja. Kan? So that is the thing. Right? Sometimes it helps. Right? And dia juga menutrient. Tapi dia bukan serap daripada pokok perumah tu ya. Available in the crevices. Not from the plant itself. Itu kena ingat. Kalau you tulis dia menyerap nutrient daripada perumah, habis sudah. Kan? Tak boleh. So it's a in between. Kan ada dirts, ada benda-benda yang terperangkap, ada benda mati-mati kat sana and so on kan. So dia boleh absorb that. Dia bukan cernakan. Somebody else akan decompose it. Decomposer ke atau kulat ke, bakteria ke akan decompose dia. Lepas dia ni akan menyerap saja nitrate from there. Contohlah. Alright. So but then they have their own daun hijau untuk mensynthesize their own food. Aku tak bagi ke ini berapa markah? Adakah dah boleh? I think maybe this one can give you like 4 or 5 marks lah. 4 marks lah maximum kot. Lupa tulis. Alright, 4 marks lah eh. Alright, okay. So this is the point dia. Don't worry, semua ni teacher akan bagi dekat description box. You boleh ambil, you boleh baca. Penting you tahu. In case kalau soalan macam ini keluar dalam SPM 2020. Right, SPM 2020. At least you'll be able to relate. Right? Relate. Dengan teacher yang cakap cerita panjang lebar kan? Okay, ini soalan terakhir. Seorang lelaki telah mengalihkan. You tahu kan pokok-pokok macam ni kan selalu jadi pokok hiasan kan? You tengok mungkin mak you pun ada. Kan? So dia nak deko lah konon kan? Dia ambil pokok ni, dia alih ke tanah. Dia kata, kau kenapa kau duduk atas, kau duduk bawah lah kan? Cantik sikit. Orang pun boleh tengok kan? So dia ingat kalau dia pindahkan dia ke bawah, dia boleh hidup dengan lebih gilang gemilang. Bukan my choice of words, right? Tetapi what happens? So kan wajar, justify. So apabila dia kata justify ini, you have to see, tell whether you agree or you do not agree. Itu dia, you kena bagi tahu sama ada you agree or you do not agree. Right? Okay, so do not agree. Right? Kenapa? Mereka memang Tuhan dah jadikan dia duduk atas pokok. Dia sudah buat susah payah beradaptasi untuk duduk atas pokok. Siapa suruh kau alihkan dia kat bawah? Kan? Macam ikan, dia sudah duduk di dalam air. God made them so that adaptation, every type of adaptation, so they can live fantastically in water. Just because they look cute, you cannot bring them out. Like the what is the movie dia tu? The Wonder World of Gumball. Fantastic World of Gumball is one of my favorite cartoon, you know. Kan the fish will go Darwin. Tu kan? Tak boleh. Dia memang adaptasi dia ni duduk di dalam air, dia duduk di dalam air pula. Kan kau tak boleh keluarkan dia. Right. So orchid ini boleh mendapatkan mineral because they are adapted to suck to get water and mineral daripada like that. So apabila you letak dia dalam kedudukan yang lebih rendah, so dia tak dapatlah air hujan tu semua. Kan? So they have to compete with the bigger trees, the superior plants. Superior means on top lah kan? Chapter 1 kan ada what is superior, what is anterior, what is posterior kan? Superior is on top of you. Right? So they have to compete for water because they don't have the adaptation to absorb water daripada tanah. Right? Okay? So ini apa ni? Untuk memperolehi air dan mineral di dalam tanah. Kan? So they have to compete. Right? So that is the thing. Because kalau dia duduk atas sana, tak ada siapa nak bergaduh dengan dia. Kan? Dia seorang saja macam king, you know. Everything dia monopoli. Apabila you pindahkan dia kat bawah tu, kan? Dia dah lah, dia tak ada cara untuk absorb air daripada tanah itu sendiri. Kan? Not as great. Mungkin boleh lah tapi not as great. Alright? Because it's, they do not adapted for that. Plus, you pergi letak dia tu, dia kena, sekarang dia kena compete with a lot of people. Alright? And not only that, dia menyukarkan orchid ini, orchid pula kan, untuk mendapatkan sunlight. Alright? Pokok ni lah kan, epiphyt ni. Epiphyt. Alright? So, kekurangan, because dia memang membuat makanan sendiri. Right? So, akan menyebabkan pada kadar fotosintesis tu rendah. Kan? Kenapa dia tak ada perkataan mati ni tak ada tak ada markah? Right? Eh, please lah. In bio, whether you go and pindah dia sana ke, pindah dia sini ke, dia memang akan mati punya. You know, mati is a very basic thing in bio. Kan? Dia menghadapi masalah ke tidak menghadapi masalah kan, dia akan mati juga. Cepat, lambat, itu saja question. So, please don't use mati as a point, you know. Kan? Honestly, don't use that as a point. So, you focus more on the argument dia. Alright? Focus more on the points. Right? Okay, so this is only 5 soalan. 5 soalan saja. Every time teacher nak bincang 5 soalan sahaja. Alright? Okay, guys. So again, teacher promise you every week teacher akan bagi video, which day I don't know, whichever day that I'm free. But for now, I think it's going to be Friday because Friday I'm a bit free now for now until your SPM. Tetapi strategi teacher kali ini ialah teacher akan membincangkan semua soalan-soalan pelik. Okay, but hot lah kan. Soalan pelik mana ni ha? Kan? Soalan-soalan pelik, soalan-soalan hot lah kan? So hopefully tu untuk memberikan kamu pendedahan. Okay, guys. So if at all you have any suggestion daripada topik ini ke, certain topik ke, please bagi tahu. Mungkin saya akan cuba cari the type of questions dia so that I can explain to you. Alright? So yeah, that's it. So I'll see you in yang ini macam part 1 lah kan, akan part 2. So sehingga you punya exam. Teknik-teknik menjawab, jangan bimbang, everything is in my channel. You can go and see, it's all pretty much the same. I've done my very analysis kat sana tahun lalu pun, it's still going to be the same. So don't worry, you still can use that. But I think this time better I address soalan-soalan macam ini. Alright, okay guys, so I'll see you the next time. So yeah, bye-bye.